Hi there, it's Kaylee. This lesson is an introduction to absolute value. Absolute value is used to measure magnitudes or sizes of quantities, like distances. Ready? Let's go! Sarah and David are standing back to back at a red flag. If Sarah takes 20 steps to the right and David takes 20 steps to the left, who has traveled the farthest? Well, they have both taken 20 steps, so they've traveled the same distance from the flag, right? They each took 20 equal-sized steps, just in different directions. But the distance they each traveled is the same length. Another way to think about this is with our number line. If we have a point here at 3 and a point here at negative 4, the absolute value of these numbers is their distance from our starting point, 0. So what's the distance from 0 to 3? Well, we need to move over 1, 2, 3 places to get to 3. So that means the distance from 0 to 3 here is 3. Now how about for negative 4? What's the distance from 0 to negative 4? Well, we need to go over 1, 2, 3, 4 places to get to negative 4. So the distance from 0 all the way over to negative 4 is equal to 4. Now, distance to 0 is the same as saying the absolute value. So the absolute value of 3 is the same as the distance 3 is from 0, which we found to be 3. Now the same is true for negative 4. The absolute value of negative 4 is the same as the distance negative 4 is to 0, which we found to be 4. Let's look at a few examples. What is the absolute value of x if x is equal to 12, negative 6, or negative 2? Well, first, let's learn a little shorthand, or the symbol for absolute value. Instead of having to write out the words absolute value of x, we can put vertical lines on either side of the number we're evaluating. Let's use this shorthand to help with our examples. So here, we're finding the absolute value when x is equal to 12. So when x is equal to 12. If I'm trying to find the absolute value of x when x is equal to 12, I'm finding the absolute value of 12. Now remember, absolute value is the distance from 0. So how far from 0 is 12? That's right, 12 spaces. So the absolute value of 12 is 12. Let's do another one. When x is equal to negative 6. So remember, I'm trying to find the absolute value of x, and in this case, x is equal to negative 6. So what's the absolute value of negative 6? The distance from 0. That's right, negative 6 is 6 spaces to the left. But direction doesn't matter with absolute value, it's just 6. The absolute value of negative 6 is 6. Okay, our last one here is when x is equal to negative 2. So just like everything else, I'm trying to find the absolute value of x. When x is equal to negative 2, I can plug that in there. So what's the absolute value of negative 2? So how many spaces, or what's the distance negative 2 is from 0? That's right, 2 spaces. So the distance is 2, and that means the absolute value is 2. Do you notice anything about all of these answers? Yeah, the one thing we notice right away is they're all positive numbers. Now you know the absolute value of a number just means the distance that number is from 0. Join me in the next video to do some practice problems and a real-life application. See you there! Hey.